What is going on, everybody? Estas here. Welcome back to another video coming to you all live from beautiful Mexico. So like you guys read in the title of today's video, and this is actually something that I've been wanting to do for a very long time, I'm going to be building a stock market portfolio on M1 Finance, showing you guys every single trade I make, showing you guys all the stocks, all the ETFs that I'm going to be holding over these next couple of months. As of right now, I simply just have $100 in my account, which is what you need to start out the portfolio. But over the next couple of weeks, next couple of months, I'm going to be funneling money into this account, ideally into a four-figure account. And I'm going to be showing you guys all of my holdings, how I rebalance, how I construct everything, so you guys can get some insight into my philosophies in a long-term portfolio. So let's hop into my computer, guys. We'll take a look at the M1 Finance app. We'll take a look at some specs about it, some cool things that I personally love about M1 Finance. So without further ado, let's get right into it, guys. Alrighty, guys, so here we are in my M1 Finance portfolio, and like I said, I have not yet bought any stocks, I have not yet sold any stocks. I have simply put in the minimum amount to start the account, which is $100, and you guys can see that right here, cash equals $100. And what M1 Finance is mostly known for is the PI setup that it allows you to create, and it's also a discount broker, meaning you don't have to pay a commission when you buy a stock and you don't have to pay a commission when you sell a stock, which is really awesome for people that are starting out with a smaller account value. Because let's say you start out with $1,000 and let's say you're with Fidelity or TD Ameritrade where you're paying $5 to $7 for a trade, you know, that's going to eat up a lot into your profits and you're going to have to make back a certain percentage simply to cover the commission. And for people that have, you know, in a $1,000 account, $2,000 account, maybe a $500 account, a $200 account, it's best, in my opinion, to use an M1 Finance, which allows you to not pay commission. It's very, very, very critical, in my opinion, when starting out and building these portfolios. So let's talk about very quickly, you know, this PI setup here that is really, really awesome and an awesome feature about M1 Finance that makes it different from all of these other discount brokerages. Let's take a look at this. So when you open up your app, when you start out an app, it allows you to create a pie with different slices. And these slices can be stocks and they can be ETFs. They can be, you know, the Vanguard Total Stock Market Index. It can be Apple stock. It can be Nike stock. And you guys can see here, I've created a pie of my own. And these are not necessarily the stocks that I'm going to be buying, but I did this simply for the example for this video so I can show you guys. So the pie that I have here has Nike stock, Apple stock, McDonald's stock, Amazon stock, Microsoft, Google, and then 3M company. And another awesome thing about M1 Finance, if we click here to edit the pie, you know, you can add stocks to it. You can change the weight of the pie until the total percentage is 100%. So let's say, you know, I want Nike at 10% of my portfolio. I want Apple at 12%. Let's say we want to bump up McDonald's to 20%, Amazon to, let's say, 18%. You can just really play around with it, add as many holdings as you want, and then shift the percentages around for it to be a total of 100%. Another cool thing about M1 Finance, and I personally don't have this option on, is you can actually have it auto-invest the money into your slices, into the percentages of your slices. So for example, if you put in $100 into the M1 Finance portfolio and you have auto-invest all of my cash, you know, M1 Finance is going to disperse that cash into the percentages that you have allocated in your pie. This is actually really, really neat in my opinion, and it makes it super easy and simple for the beginner out there that doesn't want to be, you know, trading and buying stocks on their own. They just want to put money in it and forget about it. That is really awesome for a person that's like that, right? If I put $1,000 in, you know, it's going to put $200 into Nike. It's going to put, you know, $150 into Apple. It's going to put another $150 into McDonald's, Amazon, you know, it's going to put 140 and so on, guys, right? It splits it up evenly based on, you know, how you've allocated your targets in your slices. And for me personally, guys, I don't want that, honestly. You know, I'm turning that off. So mine is on don't auto invest my cash because I'm more of a hands-on guy. You know, you guys know that, especially if you've been watching my videos for a while now. I'm an active trader. I'm an active investor. I like buying on my own. I don't want M1 Finance to do that for me, but if you are one of those people, again, that's passive, this is something that is very, very good for you. And another awesome thing about M1 Finance is this rebalance feature here. So let's say, you know, you put in $1,000 and Nike stock starts to run up crazy in price and it becomes a bit overweight in your portfolio. Let's say the target, well, it is right now, the target is 20%. You want Nike to be 20% of your target, your portfolio, and let's say the stock grows a lot and it becomes 30% of your portfolio. If you click this rebalance button, right now it's not working because the pie isn't funded, but let's say you click the rebalance function when you do have money invested in, it's going to trim off of that Nike position and then put that money that you sold from the Nike position into some of the underweight positions. So let's say Nike again runs up to 30%, you know, that's going to make it very, very overweight. And let's say, for example, 3M goes down to a 4% weight in your portfolio. What it's going to do, it's going to take money from, you know, the Nike position, and it's going to funnel it right in to 3M and maybe Google and Microsoft if those are also underweight. So this is pretty cool. It keeps your portfolio on track with the target slices that you have set, and it's just an awesome, awesome thing in my personal opinion. And that's something that you don't necessarily have to do if you like rebalancing on your own. You don't have to automatically let M1 Finance do it. But again, for the passive investor out there, that is something that is really, really awesome. So taking a look here at the research tab on M1 Finance, you guys can see the markets, SPY, which tracks the S&P 500, that's an ETF, the DIA, which tracks the Dow Jones, the QQQ, which tracks the NASDAQ 100, that's really awesome to see, you know, all the markets right there, that's pretty neat. You know, the news here, it shows you a bunch of different news, which is updated pretty much hourly throughout the day. You know, going over here to stocks, you guys can see it's pretty much just filtered by market capitalization, dividend yield, you guys have here price history, how these stocks have performed over the past year, 3 years, 5 years, their current PE ratio, and you guys can do filters here where you can be like, okay, I want to see stocks with a market cap at a minimum of $50 billion and a market cap at a maximum of $500 billion, right? And then that'll pull up, you know, all of those stocks, and you can filter with PE ratio. Let's say you only want a dividend yield, you guys can do stocks that only have dividend yields and so on and so forth, right? Let's say you want to see stocks in particular sectors, you guys can click those as well. And another thing I really love about M1 Finance, and I think it's very useful for beginners out there, is let's say you don't want to create your own pie. There's a function here that allows you to see expert pies, and these expert pies, they differ based on your risk tolerance and your time horizon in the stock market. So let's say you don't have a ton of risk tolerance, you're more of a low risk investor, you guys can see here there are different types of pies for you. So you can see the ultra conservative pie, you know, invests in the 1 to 3 year treasury bond, that's 82% of the target, you know, FTSE developed market, small cap, Vanguard S&P 500 is only 2%. So if you're ultra conservative, this can be one for you. And the 5 year performance, you guys can see it there, and you can filter through all of the different time frames. If we go back, let's say you're an ultra aggressive investor, there's also a pie for you, right? You can see FTSE developed markets from Vanguard, that's 34% of the target, S&P 500, you know, small cap, mid cap, and the bond ETF, international bond ETF, is only 1% of their portfolio. So it's pretty cool. You can see from an ultra aggressive perspective, an ultra conservative perspective. If we go back here, there's also also, you know, plan for retirement pies. You know, let's say you want to retire in 2045. There's a medium aggressive, you know, portfolio pie for you, and the list goes on, right? 2060 moderate, 2050 conservative. It's really based on, you know, when you plan on retiring. This will show you a pie that can fit your style and your risk tolerance for investing. So if we go back, one of the coolest things here is the hedge fund followers pie here. You can see some of the famous hedge funds out there, you know, Berkshire Hathaway, Icon Capital here, Value Act Capital, Paulson and Company. Let's just take a look at Berkshire very quickly. You know, this one is split into many different holdings. You have Apple, Bank of America, Coca-Cola, Wells Fargo, American Express. This is pretty much Warren Buffett's portfolio at the end of the day, right? You know, Moody's, Goldman Sachs, General Motors here, and the list goes on. And you can pretty much pick this pie, and it will invest your money based on the percentage split of the slices in this pie. So that's pretty cool as well. And of course, guys, once you funnel in your money, and by the way, I do have a link down below in the description box. It is a referral link. So if you guys do want to support me personally, you can really support me by clicking that referral link and signing up. You actually get $10 for signing up. You know, if you sign up, you can see all of these for yourself, right? And you can really go through a bunch of these different hedge fund ones, you know, just stocks and bonds, income earners, general investing, planning for retirement, responsible investing, all of these different pies, so you can see what benefits you personally with your personal risk tolerance and time horizon in the stock market. So those are kind of the main features of M1 Finance. You know, it's a discount broker. It's really cool with the pie feature. It allows you to be very passive if you choose to do so with your investing. You can literally put in $1,000 and it'll split it and invest it automatically into your slices, into the way you've divvied up your portfolio. You can rebalance it at any point in time, and there are absolutely no commissions, guys. So this is pretty cool. And with this series, I'm going to be funneling in money. Like I said, I'm planning on building this out to a four-figure portfolio. Let's see how high it can get, right? And I'm going to be showing you guys every single trade I make, every single stock, bond, ETF that I buy and hold, so I can show you guys how I construct a longer-term portfolio. And I'm not sure how often I'm going to be updating you guys. Probably twice a month at this point, because there's not going to be crazy activity here. It's not like I'm trading every single day in this account, but I do want to keep you guys in the loop and update you probably twice a month, maybe three times a month, whenever I do see a lot of activity in the portfolio. So if you guys are interested in seeing this type of series, hit that like button and drop a comment. Let me know, what do you guys think about this? And if you haven't yet subscribed and you do want to see more for me in terms of this M1 Finance series, hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell so you're notified every single time that I do make a video. And I really do appreciate all of you guys out there watching the videos, subscribing to the YouTube channel. It really means the world to me. So I'll catch you all in the next video. Have a good one. Peace out.